Know what food is all about, what it takes to produce the food we eat. Suppose that almost everything you eat is no longer available. That's very much the way it was when people first lived on the earth. Like all living things, they needed food to survive. So they gathered and caught what they could eat. Some days they had plenty of food. Other days, however, well, there had to be a better way. With the invention and the use of tools, the gatherers became hunters. Now they had a decided advantage and could count on more regular meals. Reasoning that animals which had to be hunted for food could be raised for food, the hunter became the herder. Now there was time to observe. And to think.
Did you see that?
If animals could be raised for food,
I bet we could raise plants.
With this promising idea and a little effort, the herder became a farmer. In time, with the help of sun and rain, the crops ripened and could be harvested. Soon, people all over the world learned to raise and eat the foods that grow best wherever they happen to live. In wet regions, or close to the sea, people eat a great deal of seafood and rice, also beans, green vegetables, and fruit. In drier regions, people raise rye and wheat to make bread. They eat dairy products, poultry, and meat, as well as many vegetables and fruit. In America, Indians raise corn for their grain. The new settlers learned from the Indians, and with their European ways, harvested all kinds of food. When people had learned to grow their own food, their main interest was a good harvest. With more people, they simply grew more food. One year, however, there was too much sun. Another had too much rain, and disease set in. Then a frost killed the crops. All these were serious problems.
You bet.
Until someone got the idea that if in the year when the harvest was good, enough food were raised for the year when it wasn't, there would always be plenty to eat. Not a bad plan. So with the next rich harvest, some food was put aside. Now there was plenty for the present. And if the new harvest should fail, plenty of food would be left. Or would there? How to preserve it? Cooking food would help, for a short time. Smoking some foods would keep them from spoiling. Drying food made it tough, but it lasted. Even freezing food would keep it fresh for a long time. In Asia, people used strong spices to preserve many of the things they ate, while our early settlers packed some of their food in salt so it would keep. Today, all these methods are still being used. Feeding the people of the world has become a very important industry. Large farms, new machines, and better kinds of seeds help produce our rich harvests. And we are learning to raise cattle and poultry faster than ever before. Machines also help to supply many dairy products every day. Preparing and processing foods is necessary so that all of us can choose from a great variety all year long. The processed foods are labeled, packaged, and shipped to stores all over the country. Many foods, like baked goods, are prepared fresh every day. At the market, a variety of fruits and vegetables is available to us. To keep meats fresh, some are cut, wrapped, and labeled just before they are sold. The market is the last step in getting food to us. The cost of each step along the way becomes part of the final price. Even new checkout systems are included in the price we pay because they make shopping faster and more convenient. We need to eat many different kinds of foods every day to stay healthy. A balanced diet is made up of four basic food groups. And here they are. Hey, you're on! If you want to stay healthy every day of your life, you gotta plan what you eat from four basic food groups. Just four, not five. Hey, grain foods. Bread makes a sandwich. Toast and pancakes are real nice. There's cornbread and waffles. And for pudding, there's rice. Spaghetti is a noodle, and it's made from grain, you know. But my favorite grain is popcorn, and I eat it at the show. Hey, milk foods. Say cheese.
Ice cream.
Come on, get with it. Milk comes from cows, some from goats, some from sheep. You drink it at each mealtime, and at night when you can't sleep. There's cottage cheese, soft cheese, some hard cheese that you know.
But we all scream for ice cream.
Be serious. Hey, protein foods, you're on. Meat comes from cattle, some from sheep, and some from pigs. All of it makes sausages. We serve with eggs from chicks. Ducks and turkeys are a treat.
No seafood.
Yes, shrimp and oysters are delicious.
Not to mention good crab feet.
That's crab legs, you nut.
All kinds of nuts got protein, too.
Don't forget peas and dried beans. Come on, vegetables and fruit. Let's wind this thing up. All plants have roots, and some of them we eat, like carrots, turnips, radishes, and bottoms of the beet.
What about potatoes?
They're in a special class, baked, boiled, or fried.
With meat, gravy on the side.
You like that, huh? Stems of celery have a crunch. Leafy greens are good for lunch, like lettuce, spinach, cabbage, too.
You forgot tomatoes, peppers, and cucumbers.
They're not leafy, just good for you.
Yeah.
There are apples, pears, grapes, and cherries. Oranges, grapefruit, and strawberries. All of them are sweet and juicy.
Bananas aren't juicy.
But they're good for you. You see, together the food groups supply all you need.
Carbohydrates, fats, and proteins.
Vitamins.
And minerals.
They're the building blocks of your body.
Indeed.
So if you want to stay healthy, you can never go wrong with the four basic food groups each day.
So long.
Wow, you gotta eat all of that every day? Get fat.
Or maybe sick.
Of course, eating too much, or the wrong kinds of foods, can be as bad for us as not having enough to eat. At every meal, we need at least one food from each of the four basic groups. Grains, milk and milk products, meat and meat substitutes, vegetables and fruits, so that we can enjoy good health through good nutrition every day of the year.
To stay healthy and alive.